express my sincere gratitude to our principal, sir, for providing us with various innovative platforms. And also, our college has organized various social events. This national webinar is like adding one more cap to the feather. Research is a creative and systematic work undertaken to increase the stock of knowledge. It involves the collection, organization, and analysis of information to increase understanding of a topic of issue.
Madam, not a live streaming started. Indilla. Live start, not yet started. Now only it started. Okay.
Okay, sir. The objective of the research is an important component of a research process. It is the DNA of all research process. An improper research objective will create chaos doing the research work. So now let us understand what is the important objectives and why objective is important. The formulation of research objective depends very much on the research questions that you have. Research objectives give you a working direction like a map, how to reach for answers. And what is effective paper writing? If you ask any individual, they say that paper writing is a difficult part or a challenging task. But with enough practice throughout the years in school, it could be much easier once you get used to it. Before we start with the tips for writing an effective research paper, we can get good knowledge from our associate professor, Dr. Vail Murugan, sir. Sir, it's over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. First, I would like to share my screen.
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, all. It's my pleasure to welcome you all for the national webinar on research methodology and effective research paper writing. The webinar is organized by the SST College of Arts and Commerce, Mumbai. First, I would like to thank the organizers of this webinar, the institutional, that is the college management, secretary, the chairman, and the principal, the head of the department of both, head of the departments of both IT and CS, and faculty members. It's my thanks to you all for having inviting me as a resource person for this international, that is national webinar on research methodology and effective writing. Nowadays, it is essential to know how to write a research article. What is the methodology used for writing the research article? These things are very, very important. Without knowing the basic methodology of how to write research article, we cannot easy to write effective research paper, that is the quality research papers. Therefore, we must have to know about the research article writing. Today, we have to discuss about how to write the research article by using a methodological approach. In this session, we will discuss what are the things, definition of research, types of research, technical writing, the types of research article, for what is the format for research article, and how to prepare a scientific research paper, how we can able to prepare citations and references, what is the key points of a scientific paper. Finally, we conclude this session. This is the simple agenda for the webinar today. Anyway, the base for the higher education is the publication and research work carried out by the faculty members of any kind of institute or the students of the same institute. So it is necessary to publish research articles by means of faculty members as well as by the students. It will create high impact in the higher education field. Mostly the basic things about the publication and the research is the base for the higher education. Therefore, it is essential to publish the research articles in peer-reviewed, reputed, and indexed journals. Peer-reviewed, reputed, indexed journals, if you publish your article, then only it is possible to accept by the Indian government University Grant Commission. Now we discuss what is the definition of research. First, we have to define the research. What is called as research? It is defined as a creation of new knowledge, or you can utilize your existing knowledge in order to create a new idea, or in order to create a way of solving a particular problem by means of your own concept and your methodologies, by the way of understanding your capacity. So this is called as a research. So creating a new knowledge, creating a new information, finding a new information based on your knowledge, using your knowledge in order to solve a particular problem is called as research. After solving the particular problem, you may have idea about the concepts, the methodologies, and the results. What is your research contribution? Everything. Therefore, this could include synthesis and analysis of previous research to the extent that it leads to new and creative outcomes. Most of the synthesis and analysis of the previous work are accepted or somewhat criticized by means of your own new creative results. Finally, we have to define the research as careful consideration of study regarding a particular concern or a problem using some methodological approaches. Most of the methodological approach are scientific approaches. Apart from this definition of the research, what is the definition or meaning of research? It's a common parlance. Research refers to a search for knowledge. Research is as a scientific and systematic search for pertinent information on a specific topic. In a specific topic, you have to do your research work by means of the scientific way of information gathering, by means of solving your problem by using a scientific method. Without the scientific method, it is not possible. Whether it is arts oriented, commerce oriented, any kind of research work must carry out the scientific methods, because they have to invent, they have to find out some new results. Based on the new results, they have to identify what is not accepted, what is not accepted, which one is worldwide accepted, which one is not accepted, which is accepted and how which is not accepted. Everything is carried out straight by you by means of writing a research article. Therefore, research is an art of scientific investigation. It's an art of scientific investigation, which must have a scientific investigative process, which is carried out by a person, in order to increase or revise their current knowledge of discovering new facts. Whenever a fellow doing their research work in a particular field, after their research work, their knowledge should be increased. The current knowledge of information actually by means of research work for a particular fellow is actually increased after the research work. This is the this is the main definition of the research work. What is then the research? It's a search for knowledge already given. Scientific investigation, investigative process, these things are the definitions of the research. Now we come to the discussion about the research methodology. What is the research methodology? A system of models or procedures or techniques which is used to find a new results by means of your taken research problem is called as methodology. The models, the procedures, the techniques used to solve a particular problem in order to identify a new fact, in order to identify a new research innovative idea is called as research methodology. So a set of models, a methods, a pattern, a procedure, a technique, a pattern is also called as a research methodology. You have your own research methodology. Everybody have their own research methodology. That's why the research methodology are differ from one person to another person. Therefore, research methodology is a way to find out the result of a given problem in a particular specific topic. This is also referred to as research problem. In a particular research topic alone, we can able to do research. The each and every person, those who are involved in research work, have their own research problem, which have some research methods. Each and every person, those who are involved in a particular problem solving technique, using their problem solving technique, they are all having their own research problems, which have some research methods. So each and every problem must use some different methods to solve the problems. Okay, sorry. Now, what is the meaning of research? It's a search for knowledge. We can do scientific systematic investigation. Already I have given a careful investigation or inquiry, especially through search for new facts in a branch of knowledge. A particular branch of knowledge is to be increased. Again, you have to gain a new knowledge. A tour of discovery. It is actually a tour of discovery. This is the meaning of the research. What definition for research? Defining or redefining problems. That is, you have to understand defining or redefining problems. Your own problem is defined by you. That is defining the problem. The another one is the defining problems means your own problems are defined by newly. Redefining problems means already existing problems are redefined by your own way. After the problems, whether it is defining the problem or redefining the problem, you must have some conditions to solve a particular problem. Hypothesis for that we have to form. So we have to formulate a hypothesis. After forming the hypothesis, you must suggest some solutions. So this is the technical definition of the problem. So collect for that, in order to reach your research findings, you have to collect the data, organize the data, evaluate the data, make the decisions, and reach the conclusions. This is the main point. Therefore, we have to carefully test your conclusions, whether it is used for determining the new ideas, new concepts, whether they fit the formulating hypothesis or not, whether your formulating hypothesis, your condition is satisfied by means of your results or not, that you have to decide yourself after got your results. So the research for knowledge method of finding solution to a problem is also called as research. A systematic approach must be used by a researcher in order to solve a particular problem. Okay, formulate the problem, getting the results, everything should be should have a systematic approach. Okay, now what is the objectives of research? The purpose of research is to discover answers to questions through the application of scientific procedures. You have taken a problem to solve. For your problem, you must have some scientific procedures. That scientific procedures have your setup of how to do research. What is the parameters used? What kind of research work you carried out? What type of evaluation results are carried out by you? And what kind of future action by you is discussed? For that purpose alone, you must set some objectives. Without objectives, there is no research work. Our main objective is to find new facts is the main concept of the research work. Therefore, the main aim of research work is to find out the truth, which is hidden and which has not been discovered yet. Okay, already some results are found out by others. If the same results are found out by you are not accepted for a new findings. Therefore, you must get a new results, a new idea, a new information. Then only it is accepted by research work, actually, which is done by you. Therefore, the gain familiarity with the phenomenon or to achieve new insights into it. Okay. So there are several research topics, research methodologies are available in which exploratory research, formulated research. These are some examples of the research work. Now, what are the other objectives of the research? Descriptive research, diagnostic research, hypothesis testing research. These are some main objectives of the research. Descriptive research means, what is the descriptive research? You must carry out your research work by means of describing what is what is not available, what is the maximum limit of your data, what is the minimum utilization of your data, how what your data is fit for your research, and what are the techniques are fit for your research. Everything is exactly carried out by you. That is the main concept of the descriptive research. Then what is diagnostic research? To determine the frequency which sometimes occurs or with which it is associated with something else. Diagnostic research means based on some information, you have to diagnose what is available, what is the impact of your data, what kind of data are available. Everything is diagnosed by yourself. That is called as diagnostic research. Then what is hypothesis testing research? For doing your research work, you have to set some conditions. That condition is called as hypothesis testing research. Condition is called as hypothesis. Set a hypothesis. If you choose statistical methods in order to solve your research problem, you must have set the hypothesis. Without the hypothesis, is not possible to carry out your research work. Okay, what are the motivations of the research work? There are various motivations. First motivation is to get a doctoral degree. Okay, research degree along with the consequential benefits. Desire to face the challenge in solving unsolved problems. If you have own methods, if you have own interest, you can unsolve your problems very easily. That is also carried out by you. Then some people are intellectual joy. For intellectual joy alone, they have work with their doing their research work. Then service to society to get the respectability. After completing your research work, you can get a PhD degree. So in your name, you have to put doctor, which gives a high impact on your name. for that also you have do your research. But research can be a field setting research or laboratory research or simulated research, which depends on your area of research work. Whether what kind of research work is carried out by you, everything is depends on your topic, everything is depends on your data, everything depends on your methodology, everything depends on your kind of approaches that you chosen for doing your research work. Therefore, another concept of research is clinical research or diagnostic research. You know that very well. In clinical laboratories, there are some research work are available. Suppose if you submit, that is given your blood in a clinical lab, they have to identify what kind of infections are available, what are not available, everything, what is the option, everything is carried out. Then what is historical research? Most of the psychological oriented, already available informations are called as carried out by means of this historical research. Then a time-oriented information extraction is historical research. Year-oriented, date-oriented, month-oriented research work is called as historical research. Then what is called as conclusion-oriented and decision-oriented. Initially, before starting your research work, you have to conclude this conclusion you want to get finally. In order to reach your conclusion, you can do your research work. This is conclusion oriented. For that, you must take some decisions how to reach your results, how to reach your conclusion. So everything is does research. Everything is done by your research work. But research is not called as information gathering. Without contribution of new knowledge, the research is not called as research work. Gathering information alone is not called as research work. Research is not the transportation of facts, merely transporting facts from one source to another source or one source to another destination is not called as research work. But if there is no research oriented innovative idea, innovative information based on your research career, then it is not treated as called as, it is not called as, which is not called as research work. Okay. Now we come to the discussion of the research characteristics. It starts with a question or problem. Mostly your research work must be based on a problem, which requires clear expression of a goal. To reach your goal, first you have to set your goal. Then reaching your goal, you have to express your knowledge. You have to express your information. That is called as research, one of the research characteristics. A research follows a specific plan or a procedure. Already we discussed. Okay. If you can decide your, you can divide your research work into sub problems, your entire problems. You have to do your research work by choosing a specific problem or making a question, making a hypothesis. Everything is the characteristics. Without the hypothesis, without a question, without a problem, it is possible to carry out your research work. So concepts, that is which the research work accepts certain critical assumptions, requires a collection and interpretation of data. Without the collection of data, without the interpretation of data, most of today's work, research work done by worldwide many peoples, by many peoples, are interpretation of data. What is the use of the data? What is the maximum limit of the data? Maximum utilization of data? What is the minimum utilization of data? How are the data are benefited to the real world? What are the different kinds of data are available? How, when the data are collected, when it is stored, what is the ultimate utilization of the data? Everything is called as interpretation of data. After collecting your data, you have to interpret the data. These are some special characteristics of the data research work. This, there are two kinds of research approaches are available. One is quantitative approach and another one is qualitative approach. In quantitative approach, you have to explain the concepts. What is not available, what is available. Some prediction is carried out based on your availability of the data by means of your explanation. But in the qualitative data, you can explain what is what, like a doctor's prescription, you can explain what is what it is not available, what is available, everything is carried out. We can do test the high theories, but we have to build a theories in the qualitative research. So this law, we can use large samples for quantitative research work, but in qualitative research work, small samples, known variables, unknown variables, standardized instruments, observations and interviews, deductive approach and inductive approach, these are all available. Deductive approach, you have to deduct yourself. Inductive approach, you have to find out the result. That is the different kinds of research approaches. But most of our research work may be one of the following: analytical research and applied research. Analytical research, which have some subparts: theoretical analysis, statistical analysis, multivariate analysis, analysis of an algorithm's behavior, that is performance analysis, review of a particular result, survey of a particular topic, these are all analytical research. But in the applied research, you have to apply your own mind to solve a particular problem to get a better results compared with others' results. So business data analysis using data mining techniques, machine learning techniques, AI, and some other real-time applications-oriented analysis are called as treated as applied research. Apart from these two research types, analytical research and applied research, the research is divided into two categories. One is basic research and another one is applied research. The basic research used to develop or increase your scientific knowledge, that's all. But applied research, whatever the information gathered, developed by you, your knowledge should apply in order to solve a particular problem is called as applied research. To solve a particular problem used by your knowledge is called as applied research. For doing any kind of research, you must have three steps. One is pose a question. You have to raise a question. First, you fit the question. Without the question, is not possible. Okay. So without the question, it's not possible to carry out. After the question, that is in the question, what kind of data are chosen by you? What methodology used by you? What topic is important? Results you want to produce? Everything is called as question. For that, for your questions, the question may be more than one question. So for your question, you have to collect the data. The data should answer the questions. After collecting the data, based on your data, present your answers to the questions. This is the main problem of types of the research. The other characteristics already we discussed: systematics approach, search for knowledge, movement, academic activity, helpful in decision making, and voyage of discovery, that is travel of discovery, systematic method of finding solution of a problem. These are all some other characteristics of the research work. Okay. Now need, what is the need for your research work? What is the need to get a research degree along with its standard benefits? Already we discussed provided service to the society, respectability, to overcome the problem arises in any area, which provides services to the nation. These are all some need of research work. Okay. What are the different types of research? Basically, there are four types of research work. Basically, there are four types of research work. Telecast agudha correct ah paathinga YouTube la. Okay. Basically, there are four types of research. One is exploratory research, second conclusive research, third modeling research, fourth algorithmic research. Anybody must choose any one of these four type, minimum one type or two type of research must be carried out by many peoples. Okay, therefore we have to discuss about each and every one. What is exploratory research? It is an initial research which analyzes the data, analyzing the data and explain what is what is not available in the data, what kind of data, what is the history of data, what the data actually contained, what the data is not contained, what is the limitation of the data. Everything is explained by using your own method, that is called as exploratory method. You have to explain yourself based on the availability of the data is called as exploratory research. It's a general study will conducted without having any specific end objective. There is no end objective. So what is what is available, what is not available, you can explain. That is called as exploratory research. Mostly literature survey oriented research work, experience survey oriented research work, study of a problem to have an insight. You have to choose a problem, you can understand very easily what is the problem, nature of the problem, what kind of problem actually you have chosen. Everything is called as exploratory research. Then another one is conclusive research. This is actually the test of hypothesis. You have to set a conclusion, you have to set a condition, a hypothesis to solve a particular problem. That problem is satisfied by you after solving the problem by means of your hypothesis. Then you can reach the conclusion. So that this kind of research work is called as conclusive research. Okay. So most of the exploratory research, whatever identified by you, explained by you, you can verify by means of solving the problem using any technological methodology, then it is called as conclusive research. After validating your hypothesis, you have to validate your hypothesis, whether your hypothesis is accepted or rejected or not. Everything is discussed by means of making a decision by means of a framework which is formulated by you at the time of solving the problem. So this kind of research are called as detailed descriptive research and experimental research. Without the experiment, we cannot conclude anything. So without some concept identification and understanding, you cannot easy to carry out your research work. Then modeling research. What is called as modeling research? A model is an abstraction of reality. Many of the real life problems of business situations can be formulated as models. Most of the real life problems are formulated as models. Then your model should be evaluated based on the availability of the data is called as modeling research. Solving and getting solutions for such kind of model based problems is called as modeling research. Symbolic models, mathematical models, simulation models are the examples of the modeling research. Next one is algorithmic research. An algorithm is a well-defined sequence of steps in order to solve a problem of interest in industry or business or government. The problem may be industry problem or business-oriented problem or government problem, private sector problem, any kind of problem. It should be solved by using algorithmic steps. Then it is called as algorithmic research. Solving such type of problems and deriving results for them is called as algorithmic research. This type of research fully depends on the researcher's perspective. I already informed you, the research is depends on your hand. Whatever you decide, what kind of research you want to do, based on your kind of research, type of research, characteristics of your research, the research approaches are differ. Okay. Already we have enough discussion about the different types of research: comparative research, explorative research, explanatory research, casual research, theory testing research, theory building research, action research, actionable research. Everything is treated as different types of research. Applied research, fundamental research, quantitative, quality, all these are all mostly explained already by means of previous slides. Experimental research, action research, survey research, library research, everything is explained. Then what is the steps in the research process? This is very, very important. First, you have to identify a problem. Then construct a construct a question or a set of questions. Then review the literature. Review of literature is very, very important. Then identify and label the variables. What are the different kinds of attributes, labels, variables are used in your research work? Construct operational definitions, the mathematical definitions, formulas, equations, and everything is identified by you. Then manipulate and controlling variables, manipulate variables, control the variables. If it is existing problem, you have to control the variables. If it is newly created problem, then manipulate the variables. Then what is called as a sampling procedures, you have to use some procedures in order to test the entire population data, the total data, large data. You can take a small data and then test whether your result are easily obtained by you or not. So sampling procedures that should be used by yourself in your research work. So you can make a decision based on the small results. After got your results by solving a sample problems, sample data set, you can prepare the various large amount of research work. Therefore, for that, you have to collect the data, do the statistical analysis, interpret the informations, interpret the results, finally write a research report. This is the steps involvement in the research process. Okay. Now we come to the part of discussing how to start your research. First, you have to decide your guide, choose your guide. Okay. Suppose your guide is not flexible, is not known about the research, it is not easy to complete your research work. So choose first your guide. Your guide must have knowledge about your area, or you must have knowledge about your guide area. That is the important point. If both are not known by the research problem, then it is a difficult task. Next one is select the major subject, the major domain of your research work. For example, historical research, only Indian history are analyzed, or only Pakistan history are analyzed. Such kind of major area is to be chosen by you. Major area of research work is chosen by you. Next is select a specific topic. You have to select a specific topic. Okay. In the major area itself, you have to select a specific topic. Then collect the data. The data should choose with fit to your specific topic. The data collected by you used to be fit to your specific topic. Then only it is possible to choose. Next, do the literature survey based on your specific topic, based on your data set. Some other people are done. What are the informations are done by other people? Everything is done by you by means of literature survey. After doing the literature survey, you have to apply the methods. You have to apply your own methods. Maybe existing methods or your own hybrid method. More than one method is combined by you and collected and coined by you is called as hybrid method. So the existing methods, two or three are combined in a single method is called as the hybrid method. Most of the scientific research are must have a new methodology to solve a particular problem. Next, after applying your methods based on your collected data, based on your specific topic, you have to publish papers. After publishing your papers, write the rough thesis. Before submitting the thesis, you have to write the rough thesis. After writing the rough thesis, you have to submit the synopsis. Then you can formulate the thesis. After submitting the synopsis, then formulate your thesis. What are the merits of your thesis? What are the demerits of your thesis? Whether your thesis fulfill your research work or not, everything is carried out. Finally, fine tune your thesis. Finally, you have to submit your thesis. This is the way in which you have to complete your research work. Okay. So this is up to this time we discussed about the research methodologies, the different kinds of research methodologies. Apart from this kind of methodologies, types of methodologies, the other points are also available, but it is not possible in deep. If you want, I require minimum 4 or 5 hours. That is not possible. Now we go to the writing paper, technical writing, how to write a research paper. There are 3 kinds of research technical papers. One is report and a manuscript, article, paper. Third one is thesis. Thesis is final. When we do your research work, finally you have to prepare the thesis. Before the submitting the thesis, you have to publish some manuscripts, articles, papers, research papers. Before submitting the publishing your papers, you have to do a report, prepare the report. What are the essential steps involved we require to everything? That is the main concept. One point you must know. Excuse me. What is the difference between a paper or thesis and thesis? Thesis versus research article. Research article, research paper, all are same. Okay. Thesis versus research article. What is the difference? A thesis is a long report on a short topic. In a specific topic, in a small topic, you have to write elaborately a heavy, large amount of information. That is called as a thesis. But in a research article, a short report on a broad topic, a large topic should be conveyed by you, published by you by means of a research article. That is research paper. In your research paper, a large amount of information should be written by yourself, making some new conclusions, new informative, innovative ideas. This is called as research article. A short report on a broad topic is called as a research article, research paper. And a thesis is a long report on a short topic. Then what is a thesis? It's an argument with evidence to prove the usefulness of an researcher idea. You have some your own idea. You have some idea, your own idea. Your own idea should be solved by your own method. For that, you have to prove, you have to supply the evidence. You have to prove for your proof, you have to supply the evidence. That is the main part of the research. So a thesis must have a well-prepared document. Most of us are not known very well how to prepare a well-prepared document. That is very, very important. A well-prepared document which contains and elaborately explained your research findings. That is very, very important. Without research innovative findings, there is no research paper accepted worldwide. Therefore, your research paper must have a one sentence statement. Also, your research paper must have a hypothesis, must have a formulated formula, must have a innovative information, innovative pinpoint oriented research conclusion. That is called as a research. What is the format of your research? First, title of the research paper, thesis, then first page, declaration, certificate from the supervisor, acknowledgement, table of contents, list of figures, list of tables, list of symbols, list of abbreviations, and then abstract. And then only you have to start the chapters. Chapters may vary from one researcher to another researcher. The chapters may vary from one kind of research approach to another kind of research approach. The research based on the research approach, based on the researcher, based on your guide, based on your chosen problem, the number of chapters are differ. Finally, you have to conclude your research work. That is the conclusion. Then finally, the another point is references. Finally, you have to produce the references. Then appendices. The appendices may be have questionnaire setting and other programming samples or other kind of sample information, data collection methods, everything added in the appendices. Finally, based on your research thesis, you have to, what are the publications carried out by you? Your own publications are listed in the list of publications. Now we discuss about types of articles. The types of articles. What are the different types of articles? Original research article, mini review, short communication, short reports, short letters, review articles, survey articles, case studies, methodology oriented research work. These are some various kinds of, I am not discuss all kinds of research work in this slide. Mini review, short communication, letters, communicative letter, case studies, methodological approaches, original research paper, everything is called as a research work. Okay. Now, what are the Rammi adikithu na inga dhaan irukku nu theriyilla. Okay, the types of articles. What are the different types of articles? Original research. Already your own original research work must have introduction part, methods and materials, results, discussion sections. But short reports and short letters is strict in length limits. Strict in length limits. Two or three pages reports are produced and published by you is called as short reports, mini reviews, mini reports, mini letters. These are all. But the another case is case studies. You have to consider a case, that is, you have to consider a realistic problem which is not solved or which is carried out by companies. Based on the information collected by you, you can produce a report that is called as case studies. Then methodologies or methods or hybrid methods oriented results. You have to combine more than two or three methods in a single method. Combine two or three methods into a single method is called as a hybrid method. So the hybrid method is the innovative method which is derived by you, coined by you, created by you, explained by you, elaborated by you is called as hybrid method. Okay, next we discuss about what is review versus survey articles. A review paper which reviews your result and your result is compared with others' result, then only it is called as a review paper. Your result should be compared with others' results based on the same data set, but approaches are different, methods are different. This kind of paper is called as a review paper. So on a particular result is to be reviewed by you by comparing others' results in the same data set in the same methodology. That is called as a review articles. Then another one is survey article. Based on your data set or based on your method chosen by you to do research work, what are the other people's research work actually available in the world? It should be surveyed. Doing the literature survey is the survey paper. Okay. another one is overview. Just taking notes for taking classes is called as overview paper. So it is not research paper. But there are various conference proceedings are available to publish your research work, research paper, or review paper, or a survey paper. Any paper should be presented in a conference. Then only it is published. Your research work is published. What are the different kinds of presentations are available? Research paper presentation, tutorial presentation, poster presentation, industry track presentation, virtual presentations. The another kind of presentations are available. Okay, so reports presentation. Everything is available, but it's not possible to discuss all these things within this 1.5 hour. So we can just skip it and discuss the another concepts. Now we come to the point of discussion about how to write a journal manuscript, how to write a paper for a particular journal. Publishing your results is a vital step in the research life cycle and in your career as a scientist. If you are recognized by a scientist by means of worldwide peoples, then your result must be accepted by the many peoples, the scientific organizations. Your results must be the new idea which contains the new idea, new information. Then only your result should be accepted by worldwide. Therefore, for that purpose, you have to publish your results. In order to publish your results, you have to write a research article and publish your research results by means of some journal manuscripts. So publishing papers is necessary to get your work seen by the scientific community, to exchange your ideas globally, and to ensure you receive the recognition for your results. So in order to recognize many people's, your results must be published. Without publication of your results, entire research work is waste. Therefore, it is necessary to publish your research work in order to known by other people's, other scientists. Okay. Before you begin writing, first you have to go through your topic elaborately. What is the data set available? What is the methodology you collected? What kind of information is possible to solve by using your methodology? What are the strengths of your data? What is the weakness of your data? How we can able to make contributions, research contributions based on the availability of the data? Everything should be clearly studied by you. Therefore, identify the hot topics and background reading. You have to design your study. You have to use reference managers. Then you have to choose some types of journal manuscripts. Okay, these are the very important topics. Okay. Now we come to the how to write a research paper. A scientific experiment is not complete until the results have been published or understood by others. Your scientific results should be understood by others. For that, you want to publish. For that purpose alone, we want to publish your research paper. Your research paper must have a research, original research results. So what is the purpose of writing a research paper? There are three purposes. One is the purpose of writing the scientific paper is to communicate new findings to other peoples. So your new findings are able to communicate to others, shown to others is the main purpose. Then another one is the scientific writing must use proper English, then which gives the sense and the fewest short words. You cannot use the useless words when you prepare the paper. So you must have some idea about how to prepare papers. Thus, a scientific paper has to be clear, simple, and well-ordered communication. In order to translating your idea to other people's, your new scientific findings. Your new scientific findings are translated to other people's, transmitted to other people's by means of the other people's. Okay, what are the different areas of research articles? Arts and humanities, social sciences, physical sciences, life sciences, applied sciences, and medical sciences. Everything is available. It's not possible to discuss all these things. We will skip it. Now, what is the format for writing the research article? IMRAD is the format. I, introduction, M, methods, R, results, and discussion. This method is very, very important. The IMRAD format is the very, very important format for any kind of research paper. Any kind of research paper, it is must. Whether it is arts oriented or commerce oriented or science oriented or engineering oriented, any kind of papers are actually carried out by using this methodology. Normally, methods and results are treated as called as experimental section. Results and discussion sections are combined into one normally. So methods and results section is treated as experimental section. Results and discussion section are treated as results and discussion section. But what is the essential part of a scientific paper? Title, abstract, introduction, materials, methods, results, discussion, summary, acknowledgement and references. You know that very well, how to prepare the title, how to prepare the abstract, what is the, how we can able to write introduction, and what are the materials, that is data sets are used, what are the methods, the procedures, techniques, patterns, models used in your research work. Using this models, what kind of results are produced and what is the impact of your result which is given in the discussion. Finally, summary is the conclusion. Acknowledgement may be used by you or not. It is not necessary, but references are very, very important. Therefore, a original research paper at least require the following: abstract, introduction, materials and methods, results and discussion, conclusions, references. These are the very, very important aspects which are compulsory required in a research paper. These things are how we can able to prepare. One by one, we will discuss how to create a title. A good title is defined as the fewest possible words that adequately, correctly, exactly describe the contents of the paper. Okay. Correctly, exactly, perfectly describe the contents of your paper by means of giving you an appropriate title, a particular title, a clear-cut title. Then only your title should be identified easily by many peoples and understand, readed by many peoples. Therefore, the title is extremely important and must be chosen with great care as it will be read by thousands, whereas few will read the entire paper. Suppose if your title is very well formed by you, after reading your title, they have to conclude what is already actually available, what may be available in the paper. They can easy to identify, assume that is the, in that manner alone, if you put a title of your paper, then only your title should be accepted worldwide. So for what purpose the title is very, very important? For indexing and abstracting purpose. You may know very well about the abstracting and indexing services of many journals. There are various abstracting and indexing services are available. For that, suppose if your title alone is exactly available in the worldwide, your title alone or unique title, then easily your papers are referred by many people. So for that purpose alone, you have to enter your title. The title should neither be too short nor too long. It's not too long, it's not too short, but it should be meaningful. Waste words are not used. Studies on, investigations on, the, etc. Things are not used. It should not be used. The syntax, word order must be very carefully considered. Word order. It should contain the keywords that reflect the contents of the paper. Phrases, nouns, verbs are clearly used, exactly used in your title. That is important. it should be meaningful and not general. For example, a study and the analysis of the other methods, so and so method, ABC method, not like that. This is the information. This is not the suitable title. So it should be concise, specific, informative. So informative title, the after reading your title, it should give some information, a new information. So it should capture the fundamental nature of the experiments and findings. So this is the essential for preparing a title. So the other points which are used when you prepare a title of the manuscripts, make a list of the most important keywords. Now, at least one keyword must be available in your title. Think of a title that contains these keywords. The title could state the conclusion of the paper. After reading the title itself, they have to conclude this is the conclusion of this paper. So it is not necessary to read all these things. Everything is clearly stated by you. By means of putting a specific title, it should clearly explain it. Then a title never contains abbreviations, chemical formulas, jargons, proprietary names, priority names, and other things. Okay. So think and rethink of the title before submitting the paper. Be careful the grammatical errors due to faulty word order. Avoid the use of the word using in your title mostly. But it is not possible very clearly. We cannot avoid the word using. Most of Indian papers are uses the word using. So the effective title should convey the main topics of the study, which highlight the importance of the research. Be concise, attract readers. For example, this is one of the title of my research article. You must understand here, the title of the paper is Computational Complexity Between K-means and K-modified Clustering Algorithms for Normal and Uniform Distributions of Data Points. Actually, this is my first research article published 11 years before. Here you can understand very easily the data set used for the research paper is normal and uniform distributions of data points automatically created by means of Java. Then what are the techniques used, K-means and K-modified? What is find out the computational complexity, that is runtime. Very easily you can understand the runtime between, that is performance analysis of K-means and K-modified are carried out by using this research. In this research work is the conclusion. So very easily we can conclude this paper. Next, how to prepare the authors. If there are multiple authors listed on a paper, but if you are the author of any paper, your name must be the first author. The second author and third author, fourth authors are the co-author. They are not the owner of the paper. The first author only the owner of the paper. So this is important. Next, affiliation. Your university name, institution name appears after your name. Note that some authors may be affiliated with more than one institution, which is also possible. In some paper, more than one author, more than one institutions are available. Which is the correct method? Which is not correct method? This is the correct method. This is one kind of author name, and then designation, and then affiliation, and then mail ID. This is another one kind. Author name and designation, institution name, then mail ID. But this is not the correct method. For example, star, double star, these things are not used. Star, hash symbol, these things are not used. Only one, two, first author, second author, third author, fourth author, like only you can use. Now we move to the how to prepare abstract. The abstract is the summary of your research work. So most of the reviewers are readed your abstract and conclusion. They have to conclude whether your paper are fit to publish or not after reading the abstract and the conclusion. So abstract and conclusion are very, very important topic in your research work. If you write appropriately, perfectly your abstract and conclusion, 90% of your papers are accepted. So we be careful when we prepare your research paper. The abstract is very, very important. So time saving shortcut for busy researchers like me. Okay, so I am not read out the entire paper every day when I review a paper. Only the abstract, title, keywords, the structure of the paper, conclusion, references, it's enough. Okay, the structure of the paper which contains section 1 to conclusion section. So if it is okay, then I will easily put comment to accept it and go through the publications. Everything is carried out. So sometimes the only part of the manuscript read is abstract. Therefore, you must be careful when we prepare your abstract. So many readers will only read the abstract of your manuscript. Therefore, it has to be able to stand alone. Okay. When we prepare your abstract, what are the main sections it should cover? Suppose your abstract must have eight sentences, two sentences about the scope and objectives, two sentences about your methods, two sentences about your results, two sentences about your conclusion. This is the abstract preparation. Now, mostly the abstract must be between 150 to 300 words. More than 300 words are not accepted. Below 150 words are not accepted. But in the abstract, suppose if you write 10 sentences in your abstract in a single paragraph, no two paragraphs are used when we prepare an abstract. The introduction, that is about the general topic, two sentences. About the methods, two sentences. About the hypothesis, what type of data are chosen for analysis, what kind of method, what kind of condition you chosen for analysis, and then about the results, two sentences. What you want to going to, you have to going to find out what you want, you going to find out, you find out what is, everything is discussed in the abstract. The criteria for abstract, which does not exceed 300 words, which is in one paragraph, we must use past tense, not the present tense and the future tense. No abbreviations are used in the abstract. No references are cited in the abstract. The abstract which never contain, conclude about your research findings. Your conclusion only contains your research findings, but your abstract, what you going to analyze, I am going to analyze the performance of so-and-so algorithm and compared which algorithm is best. Finally, this paper conclude like this is the method of writing the abstract. It must be accurate with respect to figures quoted in the main text. Sample abstract of the paper is given. Background objectives, two sentences. Method statistical analysis, two or three sentences. Findings, three or four sentences. Applications, improvements, future work are some other. That is applications and improvements are two sentences and go like that. Whatever I teach, dear participants, whatever I teach, all these informations are taken from this website. I am not prepared. I am preparing by choosing this website, Springer website. You can also go to find out your informations. Next, how to prepare keywords. Only 20 minutes are available. It's not possible to discuss all these things. 95 slides are available. Only 61 slides are going, went out. Now, how to prepare the keywords. Keywords are a tool to help indexers and search engines find relevant. Suppose you have published one paper. In your paper, you used Indian history as keyword. In the Google search engine, if anyone type Indian history, your paper must appear first. Then you did your research work exactly. Then for that purpose alone, the keywords are very, very important. The keywords are a tool to help indexers and search engines, which the search engines are able to find your papers, relevant papers. If database search engines can find your journal manuscript, readers will be able to find it too. Therefore, this will increase the number of people reading. The number of people reading your manuscript is very high. If you fix exact keyword, the effective keywords must be chosen carefully by you. You have to represent the content of your manuscript by reflecting the keywords. Be specific to your field or subfield. A maximum of 5 keywords, minimum of 3 keywords must be given by you in your research article. Examples of keywords: manuscript title, performance analysis of AODV and DSR routing protocols in mobile hard hack networks. This is the title. Poor keywords are networks, analysis, routing, mobile, time. These are all general words which are all not suitable keywords, but performance analysis, mobile networks, routing protocols, AODV protocols, DSR protocols, these are all specific keywords, specific areas, specific topics. Therefore, these are all better keywords. Next, we discuss about how to prepare the introduction. In the introduction section, you have to enter a background instruction about your research article. What is the general topic of your paper? What one paragraph? What is the specific topic of your paper? One paragraph. What is the method used in your paper? One paragraph. What result you want to find out in your research work? One paper, one paragraph. And what kind of comparative analysis carried out in your paper? One paragraph. Finally, what is the organization of the paper? This is in this way only you got to write the introduction parts. So the introduction part must requires 3 areas. One is your introduction must be well balanced. If any experiment is carried out by you in your experiment, for your experiment, if you require questionnaires, if you want to require questionnaires and other people's informations, you have to cite, you have to explain what kind of questions, what kind of results carried out, what type of cited informations are carried out. So it should be balanced. Current knowledge of information should be provided in the introduction part. 10 years old papers are not required. Only the current informations. Only the relevant information should be stated in the introduction. Do not write literature review in the introduction part. But sometimes some other papers, we can able to write literature survey in the papers itself, in the introduction part itself. Okay, therefore, the introduction starts with a broad basis and then narrows it down to your particular field of study. Explain the rationale behind each step. I already informed major domain, about your major domain, one paragraph. About your particular domain, one paragraph. About the methods used by you, one paragraph. About the data set used by you, one paragraph. About the results and improvements carried out by you, one paragraph. Finally, what you want to find out as a researcher, for the innovative information, it is one paragraph. Organization of the paper is finally. So this is the point. What are the purpose of writing the introduction, a good introduction? The first, it should provide background and motivation of your research paper. Already I explained. Second, it describe focus and the purpose. Already explained. It gives an overview of what is contained in the paper in the other sections. I already explained. Most of the important topic which are discussed in the introduction part is 1/3, 2/3 rule. That is, your paper have 10 pages, minimum 3 pages your introduction part must have. That is the 1/3, 2/3 rule. If your paper have 10 pages, minimum 3 pages the introduction part. So this is the 1/3, 2/3 rule. So 1/3 time to read your introduction and make a decision. Remaining 2/3 time to find evidence for the decision. Okay. So a good introduction with a good motivation is half of your success. This quote is taken from the Springer. That's why I indicated. So the introduction part must cover about the research problem, motivation of research, problems taken by you, what is your contribution, summary of and evidence of your research claim, significance of your research work, outline of the research paper. Everything should clearly stated by you in the introduction part. Next, materials and methods. So this section provides a reader with all the details of how you conducted your study, what type of data set, whether you collect the data using telephonic interview, direct method, or survey oriented method, or from Google form you can collect from your using your WhatsApp or anything else. Everything is clearly explained by means of this materials. Then what is methods? Your technology, your model, your technique, your algorithmic approach used for solving your problem is called as methods. So use subheadings wherever you required in order to showcase your materials and methods. Use always past tense. Describe how new methods are elaborated. If you want, you can develop your own method. Your own method also described by using your own words. So describe established methods briefly and simply cite a reference where readers can find more detail. So state all statistical tests and parameters in the materials and methods section. So this section describes how you do, what you did it, and give strategies, what algorithms used, sample conclusions, diagrams, figures, table entries, everything. If you require, you can show it. So this section of a paragraph of a research paper, which provides the information by which study's validity is judged. What problem taken by you, what data set taken by you, what you want to going to analyze, you want to analyze what, everything is clearly taken. Therefore, it requires a clear and precise description of how an experiment was done and rationally for why specific experimental procedures were chosen. Then, materials and methods section should contain description about the data set, description about the collection of data, description about the questionnaires, definition of formula, definitions or steps of proposed method. Everything is clearly given in the materials and methods section. Dear participants, if you want to do or get a project from UGC, funded project, if you want to get up to what I discussed, you can prepare the project proposal using up to materials and methods. Don't show it about the results, discussion and conclusion. Up to starting from the title to materials and methods, this is the way of writing a proposal, project proposal, in order to get a funding proposal, funded project from the UGC. You have to mind. Then what, which also include, what is the designing benefits of your funded project? What is the design you want to carry out? The architecture of your method and the benefits, the social benefits, the people's are whenever, whatever the funded projects proposed by you, the funded project must solve some real life problems. Then only it should be benefited for the social peoples. Okay. So also you have to give the time for the completion. The fund, if you after getting the funded project, it's not possible to submit after 10 years, only within the specific period, 6 years or 7 years, up to 6 years only, the funded project should be carried out by you. Okay. Next, we want to discuss about results. The results section contains a very important part of the paper, which describes exactly the observations obtained after an investigation or findings. This results section must contain three parts. One is text format. Your results should be explained by using your own text. And the second one is your results are tabulated in tables. And the third one is your results are shown by using the graphs and the figures. Okay, the pictorial representation of table entries are explained by means of your own text. Your own text are explained, used for explanation of the table entries and the figure entries. Therefore, all these are arranged in a sequential order to address the question hypothesis by in the introduction part. How to visualize the results? The table entries are given like the table caption, table heading are given in top of the table, but the figure heading are given in the bottom of the figure. This is the important point. So your text covers both below and after the table, below and after the figures. So before the table, before the figure, after the table and after the figure, you must write some text. It is the main part of main area of writing the good research article. Now next, discussion. How to prepare the discussion? In the discussion section, you have to explain your own methods, your own words. What is the validity of the data? What data are taken by you? What is the maximum limit of the data? What is the minimum utilization of the data? What minimum data you required to solve the problem? What maximum data you required to solve the problem? Is there any limitations available in order to utilize your method or not? Is there any limitations of using your data by means of some other methods or not? Everything is discussed clearly. Also, what about your results? How your results are benefited to the real world peoples? How your results create an high impact in the research oriented problem taken by you? Everything is solved. Everything is discussed by means of this discussion section. Why do you care about the problem and the results? What problem are you trying to solve? How did you go about solving or making progress on the problem? What is the limitations of your chosen data? How much data are useful after the processing? All the data that is chosen by you are not useful. Only some kind of data are useful and some kind of data are not useful. You can state why some kind of data are not useful. Also, you can state how the data which are useful. Everything is clearly explained by means of this discussion section. So this part may include tables, charts, diagrams, graphs. Everything should be explained theoretically and suggest merits and demerits. Now, how to prepare conclusions? Next topic. The conclusion is a summary of the research and the results of the experiment. This is where you answer your research question. Initially, you have taken some questions. You have setting some hypothesis. Your hypothesis is satisfied after getting your results, after solving your problem, after solving the data set using your method. By using your method, the data set is analyzed. Whether you have already fitted hypothesis, whether your hypothesis is accepted or rejected, whether it is fit for analysis purpose, whether it is not fit for analysis purpose. If it is fit for analysis purpose, then how? If it is not fit for analysis purpose, then how? Everything is discussed in the conclusion part. Also, you have to describe in the conclusion part how many percentage of results you got, how your performance of the algorithms, methods are suitable, how much effectively, evidently, you want to prove the results. Everything is stated in the conclusion. Next, quoting references. The references are the very well important topic in the preparation of a manuscript article. That is, we must use, there are various methods, IEEE method, MLA method, APA method, CMS method, many things are available. Okay, all these references are mostly not able to utilize. All kinds of, all types of reference methods are not used by yourself in a single manuscript. Only one method should be used. How we can able to prepare the references? MLA format, APA format, CMS format. So suppose if you want to know all these formats, you can go to the scholar.google.com by typing this entire title. So what is the difference means? Name and title, the name and year title, name, title and year appears before, and like some little differences are available in the format. Okay, how to cite sources in your research paper? How to cite sources? Book citation of books, citation of journal article, manuscript, paper, all are same. Journal article, manuscript, paper, all are same. Electronic sources citation, thesis citation, technical report citation, conference proceedings citation, paper presented at a meeting, conference, meeting are cited. These are some citation, citing references methods. Book reference, Hahn and Camber, year of the publication, title of the book, edition name, country name, ISBN number, journal article, other names, and then title of the paper, journal name, volume number, issue number, year, PP. PP means page to page. That is called as PP. Page to page. From page 561 to page 573, this article is available. Electronic sources, you got to include the what? The website addresses. It's enough. Then thesis, other name, title of the thesis, university name and year of the thesis. Technical reports, other name, report name, where the company name and year, website address. Proceedings, conference proceedings, other name, then title of the paper, conference name, volume number, issue number and year, everything is displayed. Okay, writing literature survey using references. Here, there are various ways to prepare a manuscript, prepare a paper, prepare a research article. Word format, AB. A means first other, first letter. B means second other, first letter. These two peoples are published one research article in 2009. Therefore, we can include cite AB09. AB plus 08 means what? First other, first letter. Second other, first letter, B. And some other others, that is plus. Then in 2008, they published some papers. Okay, sir. I have used the first same two others in 2009, two papers. The first paper is A and the second paper is B. And got like that. So it's a very easy direct name format. Another method, Hahn and Camber 2006. Only two peoples are available. You have to enter two peoples. Then Hahn et al. Hahn and some other peoples. Et al means some other peoples. There is no full stop for yet and there is a full stop for all. That is very, very important. Then alphabetical order. First reference start with the first name A. Second reference start with the first name B and go like that. Sequential citation means 1, 2, 3, any other name, whether it is started Z first or Y first, anything else. Okay, how we can prepare the references? Using the various reference managers, we can prepare. One of the very famous reference manager is Mendeley software. Mendeley, PipDeck, EndNote, Papers, RefWorks, Zotero, and ReadCube. These are some reference managers nowadays available in order to prepare the references. Then Mendeley desktop is very well effectively utilized in order to prepare the references, which is the software produced by the Elsevier company. You know that very well, many of you, what is the impact of Elsevier company in the research topic. So Elsevier product is Mendeley desktop. Finally, we now discuss about little bit about how to prepare the research article. First, you got to define the research problem. Do the literature survey. In the literature survey, there are two kinds. One is review of concepts and theories. Review of previous research findings. There are two kinds. After doing the literature survey, formulate the hypothesis. After formulating the hypothesis, design your research, the sample design. After designing your research work, collect the data and then set the hypothesis, get the result, finally interpret the results, produce the report. This is the sequential steps or research process in the writing area of a research manuscript. Okay, now we come to the key points to a manuscript. Key points: we must have a advanced knowledge in our research field with the evidence. Explain your idea and make them accessible to others. Definitely, there are two key components in your research paper: an explicit claim. Claim means result. On your contribution. Contribution means your research findings. On your research problem, your result must have some research ideas about your chosen problem. For that, you have to give a evidence for your result. That is, these two points are very, very important. Therefore, your contribution can possibly be a contradiction of your hypothesis. Dear participants, you have to understand first, your hypothesis may be accepted or rejected. Both are research work. But you have to explain why the hypothesis is rejected. For what reason? Why the hypothesis is accepted? For what reason? Everything is explained. Your technique solves a problem for the first time. That is very, very important. So you should avoid claiming too many dimensions or parameters. Take one or two in-depth with evidence. So in-depth method. One or two with in-depth evidence. Two dimension or one dimension is enough. So check what is your enemies for your research article. The reviewers are your enemies. So suppose if your paper want to accept by means of a reviewer, first you have to find a reviewer of a particular journal or editor of a particular journal. You can refer their paper in your paper. That is clearly explained. Choose a favorable topic. Are the experimental results consistent and conclusive? You have to decide. Already we have enough discussion about introduction. A good introduction with a good motivation is half of your success. Then reading and citing relevant papers from the premier forums is must. Provide a point-by-point statement of changes when dealing with journal feedback. Therefore, how to choose a top quality paper? Nowadays, you have chosen many databases. UCI Machine Learning Repository is number one database. There are various unsolved problems are available in the net. You can choose any one unsolved problems and solve by yourself. So then you can reach your conclusion. So after your manuscript writing, formulation of your manuscript is very, very important. Whatever the journal requirements, some journals are accepted two column format, some journals are accepted single column format, some journals are accepted 15 points, some journals are accepted only 10 points, and go like that. So based on the journals format, if you prepare your manuscript, then it will speed up your process of review period. So speed up the review period for the processing of your journal manuscript. Very, very, very important. So it can also increase your chances of success because you will not omit the materials that the journal might require. So formulating your manuscript by reviewing all guidelines of your journal is very, very important. The word limit, character limit is very, very important. The required sections are clearly explained by you or not. Whether your manuscript met all English language requirements, UK language or US language, then is there any contact information provided exactly? Inserted figures are explained by you, and the collected informations or data sets are explained by you, everything is very, very important. So correctly formulated the references, formulation of reference is very, very important. Use of correct file format, JPG, PNG, PDF, what format, any conflicts of interest, which includes details of any required ethics and regulatory permissions, obtained consent from all others, all the others, the suppose if you use more than five others, all the five others are interested to publish your manuscript in a particular journal, everything is treated as. So within this small introduction about the research methodology and thesis writing as well as manuscript preparation, I have done and explained clearly. I think so, not clearly. Whatever I know very well, I have explained. Okay. But points to remember: time, manpower, writing thesis, presentation style, knowledge gained. These are the five important points. So do your research work. The research work may differ from one person to another person, but you have to do your research work with perseverance. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you wonderful session. We didn't know how this 1.5 hour went. It was very, very informative, sir. So before ending, let me your official note.
Any questions available in the YouTube?
No, sir. Very well explained. Very well explained. And it was very simple to understand also. So all the participants are able to understand in a simple manner. So there are no questions posted, sir. Only one okay. thing, sir. Only one yeah. thing. So when we are putting images in the paper, so yes. some journals, the top rated journals, they request for high quality.
Yeah. So quality of yes. figure is are very, very important.
Okay.
You have to produce the figure. The original figure should be taken and put it into your paper. Some peoples are taken from the net. The net figures are not clearly visible. So that is important point. So you can create your own figures. That is very, very important.
Okay, sir. So you have given a good insight, sir. It was very, very informative session. So sir, anything from your side, sir, before vote of thanks?
No, nothing from my side. If all of you are satisfied with my lecture, with my webinar, I am satisfied. If you have any queries, if you have any doubts, you can visit my YouTube also. Okay, in the sir. YouTube channel, Dr. T. Velmurugan, if you type, there are various videos are available. You can visit and check it. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment to my mail ID.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir, with your permission, can we proceed for vote of thanks, sir?
Yes, please.
A lovely and warm good evening to all. It is a matter of pride for me that I can propose a vote of thanks for this national webinar. I would like to extend my sincere thanks to our principal, sir, Dr. Puraswani, and Dr. Kushbu, ma'am, vice principal and IQSA coordinator. I would like to express our sincere gratitude to our associate professor, Dr. Velmurugan, sir, who has more than 27 years of experience in education profession, and he has awarded, guided 301 MPhil students, and under his guidance, more than 15 scholars are awarded with PhD. And he has also organized N number of webinars. So we are very lucky enough to have such an expert for our session. Thank you, sir. Thank you for a wonderful session, and it was very informative. Now we understood the insight of the research, how to start and how to find a problem and how to write effectively.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I would like to place my appreciation and thanks to my colleagues, faculty members, and our college and other institution who participated in the national webinar. Last but not least, my team members, Mr. Yogesh, Mr. Myra, Ms. Deepa, Ms. Pradnya, and Mr. Krishna. And also, I would like to thank our technical team, and Assistant Professor Deepak Mulpani, who was very supportive in the entire technical show. And thank you, sir. Thank you for this wonderful session, and we had a great time with you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Can I leave?
Yes, sir.